Maxillary first molar is the sixth tooth from the midline. Its tooth number in FDI system is 1, 6 and 2, 6, in universal system 3 and 14, and in Zsigmondy-Palmer system the tooth number is 6 with appropriate quadrant brackets. It is the first permanent tooth to erupt in the arch. It erupts posterior to the second deciduous molar, not removing any of the primary teeth. Thus, like all permanent molars, it is not a succedaneous tooth as it has no predecessor. It is positioned approximately at the middle of a fully grown jaw anteroposteriorly. Due to the significance of its location, it is also called the cornerstone. Maxillary first molar is the strongest tooth in the arch. It has four well-formed cusps and a fifth supplemental cusp called the fifth cusp or cusp of Caraballi. The fifth cusp is unique to maxillary first molar and not seen in any other tooth. As with all maxillary molars, it has a strong anchorage with three roots, lingual, mesiobuccal and distobuccal. Maxillary first molar develops from five developmental lobes, one lobe for each cusp. The function of molars is grinding. Maxillary first molar erupts at the age of 6 years. Coming to measurements, the cervico-occlusal length of the crown is 7.5 mm. The length of both the buccal roots is 12 mm and lingual root is 13 mm. Mesiodistal diameter of the crown is 10 mm and at cervix is 8 mm. The buccolingual diameter of the crown is 11 mm and at cervix is 10 mm. The cervical line has a curvature of 1 mm on mesial side and on distal side it is flat. The morphology of teeth is studied under 5 aspects. Let us start with the first aspect, buccal aspect. The outline form of the crown is trapezoidal with the shorter side towards the cervix and longer side towards the cusps. Both buccal cusp, mesiobuccal cusp and distobuccal cusp are seen where the mesiobuccal cusp is larger, though the distobuccal cusp is sharper as its cuspal slopes meet at a right angle whereas cuspal slopes of the mesiobuccal cusp meet at an obtuse angle. Parts of lingual cusp, mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp are also seen. The mesial contact area by which the tooth contacts the second premolar is approximately at the junction of occlusal third and middle third, whereas the distal contact area by which the tooth contacts the second molar is at the middle of middle third. The distal outline of the crown is more convex than the mesial outline. From the buccal aspect, more of distal surface is visible than the mesial surface. This is because the crown from the occlusal aspect is rhomboidal in shape, in which the distobuccal line angle is obtuse. This makes the distal surface visible from the buccal aspect. The cervical line is irregular or slightly convex towards the root. A buccal developmental groove is seen in the middle of the buccal surface between the two cusps, which runs cervically and terminates halfway from the cervical line. Faint concavities are seen lateral to the terminus of the groove running in proximal directions. All three roots are visible from this aspect. The root trunk bifurcates at about 4 mm from the cervical line into mesiobuccal root and distobuccal root. The lingual root is partially seen and is slightly longer. A developmental groove is seen running on the root starting at the bifurcation and ending at the cervical line. Next, the lingual aspect. The outline features of the crown from the buccal aspect are same in the lingual aspect as well. From the lingual aspect, both the lingual cusps, mesiolingual cusp and distolingual cusp are seen and also the fifth cusp. No part of the buccal cusps are visible as they are completely hidden by the lingual cusps. The mesiolingual cusp is larger than the distolingual cusp, forming almost 3/5 of the diameter of the crown mesiodistally. Its cuspal slopes meet at an obtuse angle whereas the distolingual cusp is more spherical. The cusp of Caraballi is seen attached to the lingual surface of the mesiolingual cusp. It is generally 2 mm cervical to the mesiolingual cusp tip. Like the buccal developmental groove, a lingual developmental groove is present between the two lingual cusps running cervically. All three roots are visible, with the larger lingual root in front and parts of the mesiobuccal and distobuccal roots on the sides. Next, the mesial aspect. The outline form is trapezoidal with the shorter parallel side towards the cusps and the longer side towards the cervix. Only three cusps are seen: mesiolingual cusp, mesiobuccal cusp and fifth cusp. The buccal outline is generally convex with its height of contour in the cervical third. A shallow concavity is seen just occlusal to the height of contour, which was also seen from the buccal aspect. The lingual outline is smoothly convex with its height of contour in the middle third. The cervical line is convex and the convexity is towards the crown. The mesial marginal ridge is seen in the occlusal third, confluent with the mesiobuccal and mesiolingual cuspal ridges. Only two roots, lingual root and mesiobuccal root, are visible from this aspect. The bifurcation of the trunk is more cervical in comparison to the bifurcation from the buccal aspect. The mesiobuccal root is almost two-thirds the width of the root trunk at the bifurcation. The lingual root has a banana-like shape due to a lingual curvature. Coming to the next, distal aspect. The gross outline of the mesial aspect is similar to the distal aspect as well. Some differences are, only the distal cusps, distobuccal cusp and distolingual cusp, are seen from this aspect. The distal marginal ridge is slightly more cervical than the mesial marginal ridge, because of which the triangular ridges on the occlusal surface are visible. All three roots are visible from this aspect. The distobuccal root is narrowest at its base among all the three roots. The bifurcation is more apical on the distal side, about 5 mm from the cervical line.